It's a day like any other for library staff. Most will tell you they're passionate about learning and sharing their knowledge with the community. They work to build relationships with frequent patrons, but sometimes things take a sudden and dangerous turn.
We've had people who are threatened. Some have said, well, I'm going to cut your throat. They've been spat upon. They've been hit. Those are serious circumstances where somebody's not going to feel safe coming to work.
Mara Elliott is the city attorney. Her office gets involved when the victim is a city employee.
We bring a request to a court and we say we need an order to restrain this person from coming to these premises or being close to the individual who is being threatened.
Since 2009, the city has requested 39 restraining orders on behalf of workers. Almost half are for library staff, including at least four in 2019.
Good number.
Yeah, that's a high number.
In July, a man in Pacific Beach threatened four employees before using racial slurs and threatening to shoot one of them. Antonio Baker is then accused of confronting a librarian with a knife at a nearby Starbucks. In September, the city got a restraining order against Marie Treadwell after staff say she attacked a senior citizen, then threatened to slit their throats. And in 2018, Paul Mason was asked to leave the North Park Library during one of several visits. At one point, he went behind the desk and punched the branch manager in the jaw. The city attorney's office says around the same time, he also punched employees at a Walmart and Target. Police later found he was a meth user.
How effective are the restraining orders at deterring this behavior or stopping it?
They're very effective, but again, it's a piece of paper. So it is an order that gives somebody more attention. So if they call the San Diego Police Department, they say, I have a restraining order, they're going to get the attention they need.
We reached out to library staff and the union that represent them. They would not talk to us on camera, but have previously supported efforts to improve security. City Attorney Mara Elliott says the TROs are just one way they're trying to keep employees safe.
We have some security depending on the location. So if there's going to be some locations that are a little bit more prone to possibly having some conduct, and we're at a library that's seen a few restraining orders.
In many cases, the addresses of the alleged attackers are listed as unknown or shelters, but Elliott insists the restraining orders aren't indicative of the city's homeless crisis.
It's really hard to say what it is, but obviously something's wrong with the individuals who are making threats. If they're threatening to slash an employee's throat or they're getting physical and punching them or calling them names or spitting on them, your average person doesn't do that.
So far, the city has had success enforcing restraining orders. They're also educating librarians about the dangers and how to stay safe in an effort not only to protect themselves, but also the public.
Libraries are very safe places to be, and that we are being responsive. So when we see something, we're on top of it because we don't want anybody to be fearful when they go to work, and we don't want families to be looking over their shoulder concerned about their children when they visit.
Brandon Lewis, News 8.